Hi, I'm Greg Hollows and welcome to the Imaging Lab. We're going to talk about resolution in depth now. Resolution is defined as the smallest object detail that can be seen by the imaging system. One of the things that actually controls that level of detail is the camera itself and the size of the pixel in the camera. Now, it's really important to understand that that is not the only limiting detail in the system. The optics themselves and the type of lighting that's using all lead to different levels of resolution that can be obtained, and they all have to be working together in concert to get the right level of resolution out of the system or to maximize what your camera is able to obtain. Let's look at the examples here in this slide. As we look at the left-hand example, we'll see that there are two objects that are very close together. If you look closely, you'll see on the paper the orange squares have a certain amount of finite distance between them. It's very small, but it is there. In this particular camera system, they get imaged up onto the sensor so close together that they actually create one object that is 2 pixels in size. And it's really impossible because there's not enough information there to determine how close they are together or if it's one object or two or anything else like that. They've actually blended all the way together. This is where we're hitting the limiting resolution of the system. What we do in optics is we look to try and maximize the amount of contrast that we can get at a given resolution and have enough space between the objects that we're looking at when we're doing the designs to be able to get this spacing that you see in the example on the right-hand side of the frame where we're actually seeing the two objects with enough space between them. This is a line pair. That's going to be important in a later discussion where we talk about MTF. This allows us to get a frequency on line pairs per millimeter that we can actually examine the resolution and contrast capabilities of a lens across a wide range. Now, resolution, we have to understand here as we think about this. Let's put it into a real-world example. Imagine for a moment I have a piece of paper, and I have 1,000 spots on that piece of paper. And we have a camera system that has 1,000 pixels in an array running along its length. If I was to image them, like we see in the example in part A on the slide, they would be imaged all adjacent to each other across that array of pixels. This would create a line that is 1,000 pixels long. We would not see 1,000 distinctive spots. So the limiting resolution, the amount of parts we can actually break up the field into and see distinctive resolution features is 500. One on, one off, alternating. That's about the limit that we can go to with the system. Now it's important when we think about optics though, we can do this calculation on the camera side for how many pixels I have, how far I can break up the field, but what we're going to find is not all optics are actually able to resolve to the limiting level of the camera. New high resolution sensors that have hit the market have really shown this effect in detail. We're going to start looking at some real world images here and examples of test targets and real objects to see how resolution is affected in the system. So let's look at this first example here. We're looking at a couple of light bulbs, and we're going to look at two different sensors that are in play here. One is a standard resolution camera nowadays. It used to be a higher resolution camera many years ago with 640 by 480 resolution. You can see it's broken up the field into some very large areas, and we're not able to see all the detail we'd like to see on the light bulb itself. Now, with the newer cameras that have come out, we're going to look at how much you break the field up into when you go to smaller pixels looking at the same amount of area. It's a 1.3 megapixel camera on the right. And as we look at this, we're seeing that the object is broken up into much more detail. Again, we would need the right optics to maximize this capability, but let's see how it works on a target and give you some information as feedback on that. If you notice in this next slide, on the left and the right, there's pictures of a target that is there. This is a U.S. Air Force 1951 target, and it gives us resolution in the horizontal and vertical dimensions with vertical and horizontal lines, respectively. They spiral in and go to higher and higher frequencies, so we can see different resolution levels all at the same time. Now, the one thing you'll notice that jumps right off the page at you is that the resolution on the left is far lower than the one on the right. Now, understand that the sensors are the same size in this particular example, as well as the optics, lighting, and working distance. The only thing that has changed is the actual spatial resolution on the image side. And that's why we're seeing much greater detail on the right-hand image. And that's to be expected as we go to higher resolution cameras. Now, one caveat to that is that in this system, the lens that was utilized has higher resolution than either of the cameras can produce. So we are not limited by the lensing system in this example. Let's take this a step further now. Let's look at two high resolution cameras with different lenses on the system. This is actually looking at a UPS label. In that label, there's a variety of detail there, 1D barcode information, 2D barcode information, some centering circles that are there, and then text. Very popular application to read the barcodes, read the text, and do a variety of different OCR and OCV applications. We're using a 2-megapixel camera for both situations here, and the lenses have the exact same specifications. If you looked at the specification sheets for each of them, they would be essentially identical. The important thing to take away here is as you look at the close-ups of these images, in the upper corner where the 2D matrix is, you'll see a wildly different image being produced between the two of them. In this example, the image on the right is actually exceeding the sensor's capability, while on the left, the optics do not meet the sensor's capability. This is why we get this run together of the data in the 2D matrix. And while it may be readable in this application, it would be much less reliable than the one on the right. It's important to understand that the specifications of a lens, while looking very, very similar, does not mean that they actually perform the same way. Why is this? First off, it could be the design. It cannot be designed for this specific area, making it not perform as well. There might be corners that were cut or things that were done to reduce cost in that lens, taking away elements or limiting the size of it for other applications. That would actually make it have the inability to hit that performance level or lower cost manufacturing tolerances that are employed. That'll give a stack up of errors that could actually reduce the quality of any of the given lenses that are there. At the end of the day, the resolution is very important to guarantee the reliability and the repeatability of the system. Just because I can get it done once in the lab doesn't mean it's going to work perfect every time afterwards. So it's important to look at that. Let's take it a step further now. We're going to get into how that we can look at detail of lenses and determine what's going on across the entire field of view. In the next slide, we have an example here of a certain type of target. It's called a star target. You'll notice it's a circle with wedges alternating black and white going towards the center. Kind of like slices in a pie or a pizza, you'll notice they get narrower and narrower as we get to the center of the image. The frequency is going up because the line spacing is getting tighter. This allows us to evaluate different resolutions continuously over the entire area of the target. In the next slide, what we're going to see is we place a variety of these stars in different positions on the actual target itself. This allows us to evaluate resolution in every direction at a variety of frequencies all the way through the system in the center and the corner. What we're going to do now is we're going to pull up comparisons between two lenses and look at the center and the edge and then the corner of the image, and you'll see wildly different results. Some things to take away here as we get down to the corner of the image, you'll notice that the center, they're very similar. We get to the corner, they're very different. You'll notice that the resolution on the right-hand side is actually falling off differently in one diagonal dimension as opposed to the other. This can be a problem associated with higher order issues in optics, specifically astigmatism and some other aberrations, but you'll notice here that you'd be able to get resolution in one direction but not the other with this particular lens. So if all your defects are going one way, it'll work, the other way it may not. Resolution is a critical thing in all of your imaging systems. Next, we're going to look at how we tie contrast together with this so that you can actually get a specification at a given resolution to compare lens systems. That's a detailed look at resolution. Next is contrast.